Byron New York, chief political correspondent at the Washington Examiner. He joins us tonight. Byron, we're going to use inside voices now. So you just heard Congressman Sherman, who's sitting still right next to
me,
say, in effect, it's not a big deal that the Hillary campaign paid for this dossier,
right,
or that the Podesta group was lobbying on behalf of the Russians.
Yeah.
Are you going to like talk about me?
We're going to talk about it. Yeah, right, right here. Wasn't a big deal.
Yes, it was a big deal. But even before we had this revelation from the Washington Post that the DNC and the Hillary campaign had paid for the dossier, even before
right.
we knew that, I think you saw a shift in tone among Democrats away from collusion.
And started yelling about the tax bill?
No, they were talking more.
Oh.
They were talking about Russia's active measures in the campaign. And Russia did have a campaign to influence our presidential election. There's no doubt about
right.
that. And indeed, you see what the articles of impeachment are about: obstruction of justice, about the president's firing of James Comey. In other words, you get to a point where collusion doesn't matter. So you don't have to prove that. It's
right.
just that the president obstructed justice.
We've repainted the slogans on the barn. We never
yeah.
said that.
Yeah.
We're just moving on to that.
But I think what has happened now is, after an attempt to paint Russian involvement as a one-way street, where the Russians were trying to hurt Hillary and help Trump, and Trump was somehow dealing with them, I think we've seen it's a much more complicated picture, because it is a fact that this foreign agent, the former British spy, Christopher Steele, did get information from Russians who were connected to the Kremlin. You just look at the dossier. The dossier has source A and source B and source
right.
C, and they're identified as, you know, a senior Russian foreign ministry official, or a former senior Russian intelligence official, or a senior Russian financial official. So it's not a secret that they're dealing with people who are in the Russian government connected to the Kremlin. So what has changed now is we're now seeing these Democratic efforts to get dirt on Trump from Russia. And that does sound suspiciously like what Donald Trump Jr. thought he was going to get in that June 2016 meeting at Trump Tower, when some Russians had approached him and claimed to have had some sort of dirt on Hillary Clinton. They didn't, and that's not what the meeting was about. But it's very similar here.
Interesting. We still have the Congress. Would you like to interject?
My articles of impeachment have always been about obstruction of justice. It's not the crime, it's the cover-up. We've got three different instances of violation of Section 1512. They do not whether Trump colluded or he didn't collude. He tried to stop the investigation of
Are
Flynn.
You a little embarrassed? Tell me you're a little bit embarrassed by these revelations.
I'm not embarrassed at all. What I'm embarrassed
what would embarrass
is that
you?
We're not here talking about impeaching a president
oh,
and stopping a bad
thing. The things that you think are important.
Yes.
Oh,
the
okay.
things that are important to the American
oh,
people
the things
is
are
who's their president and what's their tax
okay.
bill. Not whether right. the last candidate for president had a good campaign or didn't have a campaign.
We've
and
had you on
silly
many times
as,
to
It's
talk
as
about.
Silly as trying to say that Richard Nixon should be in office
now we're back
because you have dirt on George McGovern.
So let me,
That's
thank
insane.
You, thank you very much. You rose to the occasion. Let me just ask you quickly, given the performance you just saw from Congressman
yeah.
Sherman, if Democrats were to take control of the House of Representatives in the midterm election a little more than a year from
yeah.
now, how long would it take, do you think, to impeach the president?
You know, I think that's a bit of a fuzzy question, because go back to 2006. George W. Bush's poll numbers are in the tank, and it looks like Democrats are going to win the House, which they do. But early on in the election, before the election, John Conyers, who stood to become the chairman of
yeah,
the
I remember.
Judiciary Committee, was talking about impeaching President Bush. There was a lot of talk from the left wing of the Democratic Party about impeaching Bush, so much so that prior to the election, Nancy Pelosi, who stood to become Speaker, came out and said impeachment is off the table
right.
because they didn't want the election to be about impeachment. And if you have a lot of talk about these articles of impeachment coming up to next year,
that's a good point.
Look what could happen.
We'll talk about the commercial break. We're out of time. Would you like to read the tease, Congressman?
I'll read the tease. The Post: Weinstein backlash against sexual harassment is consuming a top political analyst at MSNBC, but what are the risk of accountability turning into witch hunt? More right-wing take on this will come up right after the commercial.
Thank you.